Hey, what's up, Street Togs? This is Eric Kim from the Eric Kim Street Photography Blog. This month's Fiesta Movement Challenge is for me to follow an artist for a week. One street photographer I really admire is a guy named Jack Simon. He's based here in the Bay Area. I'm going to go see him in the city, learn a little bit more about his craft, see him working in action, and I'm going to drive him to the city. All right, see you guys there. Peace. All right, so with Jack Simon and the Mission. So, Jack, can you tell us a little bit of why you like shooting here in the Mission?
Lively, it's diverse. On this street, it feels a little bit like Mexico, but it's mixed, and also I like street art. There's a lot of street graphic, street art around.
Uh-huh.
Good food, too. One block over,
uh-huh.
You're on Valencia, and
uh-huh.
It's a totally different vibe. Coffee shops, interesting stores, one of a kind, and a lot of street action, too.
Cool.
A lot of people on the street.
And can you also show what you're shooting with today?
I'm shooting with my X100 S.
Uh-huh.
And also in my car I have an XE1.
Uh-huh.
So I might take that out later. But this is what I mostly shoot with. This is a fixed 35mm
uh-huh.
equivalent.
Yeah.
And I have a zoom lens on my XE1, which was the kit lens that came with the camera. But uh-huh. if I want to go out with a zoom, I'll use that. And I hardly have ever used zooms over the last 5 or 6 years.
So why do you prefer primes over zooms?
I know what I'm going to see.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I know in that perspective what's in front of me. I can lift up the camera to my eye or not.
Uh-huh.
And I get a sense where I have to stand. And also reduces one level of decision.
Mm-hmm.
On the other hand, I'll miss shots sometimes because it would be better if I was at 50 or even 80, although generally I'm between 28 and 50.
Mm-hmm. But 35 is kind of your ideal?
Well, it is because that's what's on this camera.
Okay, cool.
But for a long time, 28, I had 28
uh-huh.
prime on my Nikon.
Yeah.
And a manual focus lens that I loved, and that mm-hmm. was my ideal because that's what was on the camera. On the street,
uh-huh.
Just where we're happy to meet up, is a spot where you've seen one of the photos, although not typically Jack Simon photo court.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Anyway.
Maybe we can walk over to it.
Yeah, I'm a skateboarder.
Yeah.
Skateboarder was using this ramp.
Oh, wow.
Come up the ramp and
uh-huh.
over the top.
Oh, wow.
And so he was practicing a little bit,
uh-huh.
and I watched him for a couple of minutes and then happened to catch, for me, which was the shot that made it for me, was an older man with a cane on
uh-huh.
one side, a postman between them looking at them, and I just kind of liked that general setup of the shot. So,
oh, cool.
Anyway, but most of my shots don't have a lot of action to them like that. I paired that with another action shot of someone flying through the air, but I'd say most of my shots tend to be a little bit on the quiet side. Kind of cliched shot that I at first I thought was very cool, but now
uh-huh.
I realize everyone takes that shot.
Yeah.
You see someone's legs
uh-huh.
below kind of your roll. So you kind
uh-huh.
of pair their legs and with that. But you know, they're all over the place. So it'd be fun to find something a little bit more unusual. But I like all the street art.
So what about street art do you like?
One is I like art.
Okay, uh-huh.
I like art.
Like
painting. And I like the fact that it's in the street because I can be walking around
uh-huh.
neighborhoods. I see it. It kind of blends in with people's environment. It
uh-huh.
takes it out of the museum.
Uh-huh.
And a lot of it is a little bit more a mixture of naive, you know, what you'd say, like folk art.
Yeah, yeah.
But some of it is really quite beautiful and refined. And,
uh-huh.
And then I like for street photography, it makes a colorful background. Sometimes you can find something interesting going on that
mm-hmm.
Melds with the actual specific art.
Can you also describe maybe like the settings you like to use on your X100S when you're shooting in the streets?
Yeah, I tend to focus. I mean, a lot of people use zone focus
yeah.
for street photography, but
uh-huh.
I tend. And of course, when I had my manual focus
yeah.
lens on my, which was only manual focus on my Nikon,
uh-huh.
I would shoot in a range. But here, I tend to shoot
Well, it's a little dark right now. I have it at 8, but I also have my flash on right now. And most of the time I don't have flash on, but it's kind of dull today and I want to see what it picks up. So I have it at F8 and and then it's a mixture, but I'll often be at F8. I have it on aperture priority.
Yeah.
So it'll choose the aperture. And with this particular camera, I keep it on. I don't know if I have it set that way. It's interesting. Occasionally, I don't.
Oh, what?
I realized I didn't set and it's fine. What a photographer should do every day when he takes out his camera is go over the main settings and make sure that it's set for...
what were you supposed to set it at?
I set it at ISO auto. Starting at 400 or 200 and it'll go up to 6400.
Yeah.
I was shooting in a darker environment the other day. I didn't want it on auto and I had it at 1250. So it's at 1250, but it's fine. It'll catch. Today is a perfect day to be at 1250. This camera is excellent at high ISO. There won't be any noise at that level. And so 1250 was fine. In fact, it was a brilliant idea, even if I didn't
have it. You did it on purpose.
Even if I didn't have it. So it is a good idea to check your settings when you go out. And it's interesting. Here you asked me about settings, and that's what got me to think about them.
Oh, nice.
But you know what? I'm not going to even change them yet. I'm going to keep it on 1250.
Cool.
We'll see what happens. But I will change them at some point. So we're...
happened to shoot the picture across the mural. I didn't know I was. I mean, that was just a mistake. But the hands were in the exact same position, which is kind of fun. But I don't know what the picture looks like, but it probably isn't a pretty good picture. But that was just a mistake. There are people who pass out Bibles in the mission. I think that's a group that's coming toward us right now.
Yeah.
So I know you know, we both take different kinds of photographs. I mean, each of us will take different kinds depending upon what the circumstances are like. And occasionally I'll do just what you did, is ask someone for permission and do more of a street portrait.
Yeah.
But what I was planning to do before you asked him, and it wasn't necessarily a photograph that is a keeper, but I was looking at these graphics over here, but I was mainly doing that to pretend that that's what I was going to take a picture of. And then I would, but basically I've taken a picture of him in that. And the reason is that, now here's a guy who's walking down the street that I want to get.
Oh, there's a good combination of people who just walked by.
I know. You know what happened? I was wondering why I couldn't get... I'm running out of battery.
Oh.
Oh. You know what? I think I do have another battery with me. I did. I was wondering why I couldn't get... That was a good combination.
That was really good. Chance favors the prepared. That was great. The second you brought up your camera, all the puzzle pieces just seemed to line up.
Well, I want to see what happened because I couldn't get it to go off when I wanted it to, but it did.
Oh,
so
cool.
It finally went off, and then I had no control over it because suddenly someone else walked in on the bottom of the frame with that dog, the man. I'm not sure it's a worthwhile photo.
Yeah.
We'll see later. But that's an example of the chance takes over. It did not flash when I wanted it to.
Oh, man.
I think because I was running low on that. Let's see what happens now. I wasn't able to see the... Yeah, now I can see what's going on. Oh, the other thing about this camera, since you're interested in technical aspects, is the camera has two different kinds of viewfinders.
Oh, okay, uh-huh.
And I was on the electronic viewfinder, which will show me exactly what's in the scene.
Yes, yes.
But now I have it on an optical viewfinder.
Uh-huh.
And the optical viewfinder is a little bit like your camera, your Leica, that I'll have a square, but then I see the action outside. So I can watch it coming in. And it's very bright because it's clearly it's just optical. And I'm getting...
So which one do you prefer? Optical or electric viewfinder?
I go between the two.
Uh-huh.
I like the electronic because I see just what's going to be in that frame.
Yeah.
But if there are things coming from the outside, like we're on a street and people are walking along and I want to see who's coming into the frame, then I'd rather be in the optical. Although sometimes if I do the electronic, chance occurs, occurrences are better than my plans.
Oh yeah, that's great.
I like both.
So whenever you see an interesting scene like we see behind us, how long do you usually stick around before taking before moving on?
Well, if it's really interesting and the light is beautiful, I may stay a few minutes and hang out. Most of the time, I'll take one photo, two photos maybe. Mm-hmm. And but this is actually a pretty good scene. So it's
So what did you see?
I want to get, there are three tourists, they look like probably from the Midwest, wheeling their luggage.
Yeah, yes.
Past, and I kind of got him, I wanted to get him in between the people.
Yeah.
But you have to understand, I'll come home from a day like today and I'll have some photos that I think are decent photos.
Yes.
They may not be any that I really feel are special photos, something that I really am wanting to collect.
So how long does it generally take for you to really understand or realize if a photo is good or not? Is it usually instantly, or do you have to sit on your photos for a while to figure it out?
It's sometimes instantly. More often, I certainly have to see it on my computer, see it uploaded.
Yeah.
I don't get enough of it. I may have an idea that it's pretty good, and I'll look at the viewfinder. I'll look at the LCD screen and see the image, but usually I'll see it on, and then sometimes it's instantly, and sometimes I won't be aware for a couple of weeks. So I'll come back to it, and sometimes it's months, or my taste changes, and I come back. Occasionally what's happened is I realized when I first started with photography a few years ago, I cropped a lot of photos.
Oh, yeah.
I liked everything closer, and I thought that was... I thought that was more interesting, and now I've gone back and seen that some of my photos that I didn't think were particularly that interesting anyway.
Yeah.
They were so cropped that when I uncropped them and opened up the scene, I like the way they look now.
So, oh, really?
So I think my taste has changed.
Uh-huh.
But those aren't necessarily like still finding something that I think is a real special photograph.
Mm-hmm.
But I save them, and I'm hoping someday my... You know, maybe one of the days my taste will change so much that I'll really like them.
Yeah, great.
But this is a good scene here because a little interesting background. Yeah. When you ask me about hanging out in an area and how long I do it, I did do a workshop with a fantastic magnum photographer, Constantine Manos.
Yes.
And he talked about hanging out in an environment to watch and take photographs over some time, and because of my style of 1 and 2 minutes or a few seconds,
yes
I thought maybe he'd be there for 5 minutes, and I watched him and he blended into the scene in a fair state fair that was going on and blended into the scene. And he just stood there, I'd say, for 45 minutes to an hour.
Wow.
He really, and after a while, people were just walking around him, and he basically, that was his style of really watching the scene.
So, what, this is one question I have for you too, Jack, is, what do you think makes a great street photograph?
Whoa. Well, yeah, there are very different styles,
yes,
of street photography, and I like lots of different styles. So, I mean, you were taking a, I would call it a street portrait,
mm-hmm,
but you asked the person and
yeah,
got them into a certain environment, and that's one type.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'd say the bottom line is I like the photograph to look good.
Yeah.
And so if the photograph turns out, it's good composition, maybe today we're not going to get beautiful light, but sometimes incredible light is beautiful.
Yes.
To me, that's very important. Then we deal with content.
Mm.
And lately, as I mentioned, I like a scene that might tell a story,
uh-huh,
but not necessarily about what's actually going on.
Mm.
There's a certain ambiguity to the scene,
yes,
the moment, and the way it's framed that, uh-huh, may tell a different story. So I'm attracted to that.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll look at images like a Gregory Crutzen,
yes,
who stages everything,
uh-huh,
Jeff Wall,
and yes,
puts together in a beautiful, I don't know if that's, I guess, whether you'd call that street photography or not,
yes,
because it's posed, it's, uh-huh, planned.
Yes.
But if it's a beautiful photograph, I love it. For me, and because what I do, and I don't have the capability of doing that kind of planning. And
yes.
For me, if I can find a scene that,
uh-huh,
that has a certain beauty and mystery to it, I love it. But I like the different styles. And we were just talking about, I love these gritty black and white styles that some photographers are capable of. And some people use flash in a way that's quite beautiful on the street. And there are lots of different looks to it.
And what do you, for yourself personally, what do you think is the most difficult or challenging part of street photography?
I think it's finding something that makes a unique statement. And that's kind of funny words. Let me say a little differently. You walk along the street,
yeah,
anyone could take a particular scene.
Uh-huh.
And so if we're walking along, everyone has their cameras with them and their cell phones and they're taking pictures. To me, the difficult part is taking something that might be a little different than,
uh-huh,
what might be normally seen.
Uh-huh.
And that's a challenge, and that to me is the most difficult part.
Mm. Okay, yeah.
One thing you had asked me a while ago was my use of reflections, which I do like very much.
Yes, yes.
And what I like is the complexity that can potentially occur.
Uh-huh.
I mean, I don't think there's anything necessarily here that's a keeper.
Yes.
But we've got the kind of glass that's a little dirty. We've,
yeah,
got, and just getting up right now.
Uh-huh.
Which I like people changing position.
Yeah.
And then we have reflections. We have him twice. We have Mickey Mouse. But again, it probably won't amount to anything in particular.
Yeah.
The other thing, I probably, I don't know if I mentioned before,
uh-huh,
but I'm pretty spontaneous and pretty quick,
mm,
and not thoughtful. I said that to you in terms of colors and things.
Yes.
Somebody just grabs my eye,
uh-huh,
take a photograph.
Yes.
Most of those don't amount to anything,
uh-huh,
but occasionally there is something interesting that's gone on.
Yeah.
And I like to think,
uh-huh,
that it's partly luck, there's no question, but I also,
yeah,
like to think that maybe my unconscious or somehow I caught a glimmer of something that made it into an interesting photo. So I'd like to think it has something to do with me too.
So maybe the subconscious, the psychiatrist in you talking.
Exactly. Exactly.
That's awesome.
But I mean, you know, I can't see it all. I mean, you get to a scene like, you walk up to a scene like this.
Yes.
And there's dirty glass,
a poster, reflection, someone crossing the street, to see all that. My mind, I mean, if I slowed down and looked at it carefully, I probably could get an idea of for a photograph, but it's not the way I function. So for the most part, if I'll walk up to something like this, quick look, take a photograph, and move on. Occasionally, if it really looks interesting to me, I will, I might really study it a little bit more, put my eye into it, spend a little bit more time, and try to come up with an interesting composition. But for the most part, I like this woman hugging this. Everyone will take that photograph, or can take that photograph, so it doesn't mean it's not necessarily going to be anything interesting.
Yeah.
But it catches my eye, and it's, and I'm compelled to take it. You know, I enjoy the hunt, basically. And even though the chance of finding something isn't always that great, or finding something that I'll find very interesting.
Yeah.
The hunt is interesting.
Yes, yes.
Although, as I've also mentioned to you, sometimes it can get discouraging too, because I can spend days where nothing's very special has arrived into my camera, and then I start to wonder, will it ever occur? When will I find something? It's easy to get a little discouraged too.
So how do you stay motivated?
One thing which I've mentioned, which does motivate me, is to find something interesting to do.
Yes.
And also a good cup of coffee.
You're like me. You can love the coffee too. Yeah. Street photography is just an excuse to get coffee.
Exactly. Good pastry. And maybe an opportunity of talking to someone on the street occasionally occurs that's interesting.
Mm-hmm.
That'll keep me interested, but it can get... and I have to then go back and look at and say, well, I've gotten photographs that I've liked before, and I'll go back and look at pictures I've taken, but it's difficult. From over 7 or 8 years
yes.
of taking photographs,
maybe
I have 200 photographs.
Wow.
That I like a lot, and maybe 100 that I think are pretty good, and then I'll cut that further into ones that I would be very proud of and
yes.
might be able to get, you know, someday into another book. And so it maybe one a month might occur.
Wow.
When I look at the numbers that way, of the ones that are very special to me.
Mm-hmm.
But I also will end up coming home with a few photographs that I'll enjoy.
Yeah.
And I like looking at. And I'll keep on my computer and with my own enjoyment.
That's great.